Kitchen, provided by Floor & Decor.
It smells so good in here. Christmas is about a week away, and we have the breakfast that is going to make your morning. Charlotte Hansey is in the kitchen with me to share the recipe for chocolate gingerbread sticky buns. The gingerbread already smells like Christmas in here, doesn't it?
It's like my favorite holiday flavor. I love it so much. And I saw online that you could do like cinnamon rolls, sticky buns with puff pastry, but I can't just make them normal.
No, you've got to make them outstanding.
Yeah, so I'm like, what is my favorite holiday flavor? Gingerbread. And I wanted the filling to taste like gingerbread.
So you made this up.
Yes, and I even wrote to my friend who bakes, and I'm like, is this weird? Because I want the filling to be like a gingerbread cookie taste. She's like, no. I think it's amazing.
I cannot wait.
Yes, so I came up with this filling. It's so good, and it's so easy.
Okay.
So first, let's prep the dough. So it's just puff pastry. It's the
you get this little guy.
Yeah, it's frozen. It's in the store. It's done. You just have to let it thaw for like 30 minutes, and it's ready to go.
Okay.
I like to roll it out just a tiny bit, because see how it's kind of got a little bit of like cracks on the seam, just a little bit. And you're not rolling it out to thin it out. You just kind of want it
smooth.
Yes. And your surface is floured, and this already has a lot of flour on it. It's so easy to work with because of that.
When you say easy, I'm in.
I know.
Especially when it comes to baking.
I'm not a big fan of making the dough and letting it rise and rolling it out and all of that.
No, it's too much work.
Yes,
Christmas is too much work.
Okay, so the dough's ready. So we just kind of roll it
ready.
Out. Yes. So the filling is so yummy.
I can see that this is definitely a Christmas morning thing.
We start with butter, softened butter. To that, we're going to add brown sugar. Okay,
beautiful.
Like 3/4 of a cup of brown sugar.
Am I mixing this?
Yes.
Okay.
Go for it.
With the Texas spatula, because you're...
Yes, of course. Yeah. I have to bring that, especially when I'm cooking with you. Then we're going to add molasses, and this is where it's going to give it that gingerbread flavor.
Okay.
And this is about 3 tablespoons of molasses.
Uh-huh.
Yummy, yummy.
I got to scrape that because we don't want to leave any of it in there.
And then it's all of our traditional gingerbready spices. So we have cinnamon.
Cinnamon, nutmeg, allspice, all that stuff.
Ooh, we've got a cloud.
Yeah,
and then this is nutmeg, ground nutmeg. We've got cloves.
Cloves.
And I go heavy on all of this because I want the flavors to be really pronounced and strong.
All right.
And then we have 2 teaspoons of ginger.
Ooh, I just made zucchini ginger cookies.
Oh my gosh.
And they were so good. The ginger part was delish.
And then you put the zucchini in it, and it makes you feel a little better about
They were completely healthy. Completely healthy. It was like a breakfast cookie.
Yes.
For sure.
So look at that. That's your filling.
Okay.
Isn't that easy?
Yes, and that was
so
easy to stir together too.
Yeah.
All right.
And so all we're going to do is we've got that mixed together. I'm going to set this aside, and then we're going to spread it on. Well, actually, I'm going to use that for about half of this, because this comes with 2 sheets of puff pastry, so it'll make 12.
Ooh,
so this will make 6, so we're going to take half of this filling, and we're just going to plop it on there, okay? And then you're just going to spread it on.
And do I spread it to the edges?
Not quite all the way. And so it has all that flour on there, so you kind of have to be...
Get aggressive with
it. Yeah, you kind of have to get aggressive with it. And you're going to spread it out to almost to the edges.
But not quite all the way.
This has made me like want to do so many different flavors. Like, I have so many in my head, like chocolate praline. Can you imagine doing like a chocolate filling and then doing the praline?
That'd be good for Thanksgiving.
Yes. You could do pumpkin. There's just so many different like combinations that you could do because this is so easy to work with.
Okay.
So that's all you do there.
All right.
Then you just roll it up like you would a cinnamon roll. Okay, so we're just gonna roll. And it's so...
And because you have all the flour, it does make it easy.
It's so forgiving, it's so easy to work with. And so you're gonna roll it up.
And you make us look like pros. Because they look so gorgeous at the end.
Yes.
And this is easy to do.
Yes, okay, so you've got it rolled up, and then you're gonna cut it into 6 pieces. So I do 1 in the middle, and then I just kinda eyeball it.
The 3, yep.
Okay, and then so you put it in a muffin tin, and the reason you do that is so because it's your pan's gonna be a mess. It's going to bubble up and get all sticky and delicious.
Well, that's what
so,
we want.
And then the puff pastry would puff out if you didn't put it in a muffin tin.
Oh, okay.
So that's
so it's gonna contain the puff.
Yes, it contains the puff.
Okay.
So then you would do that again with the other pastry sheet.
The other 6.
And then
bake them for how long?
It bakes up for about 20 minutes at 400 degrees.
And then what's the frosting? Oh my gosh.
So
I
already have the frosting made, and it's a white chocolate frosting. So you melt white chocolate chips, then you add your butter, cream cheese, powdered sugar, vanilla,
and
it makes the most delicious. And I just stick it in a Ziploc bag, snip the end off.
And then you put a ton.
And then you
on
can just
one.
Drizzle it on there.
I love it.
Like that.
All right, if you want this recipe, Charlotte, yes. You're amazing. It's abc4.com/GTU. This is the Christmas special surprise breakfast that everyone needs with a cup of coffee.
Exactly.
Or whatever you want.
Yes.
Charlotte, thank you so much. I can't wait.
You're welcome. Oh, yum, huh? Tastes like Christmas.
The filling, and there's a lot of it.
Yeah.
You're the best. We'll be right back.
Cabinets and mantle for good things Utah provided.